Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll talk about another interesting topic, that is EasyBI. By using that, we'll build customized dashboards or customized chart within our Jira instance. I've already created one video using custom charts, so feel free to refer that video from the link in description. In previous video, I've used custom chart created by old state solutions, but in this case, I will use here EasyBI. With the help of this, we'll build interactive and interesting dashboards for our projects. So let's get started. Generally, when we are creating dashboards or reports, these add-ons or third-party add-ons are helping us to make interactive dashboards. Without customizing anything, we can directly use these add-ons. But if you want some more interesting factors to be included, definitely you have to customize it according to your need. Now, for installations, simply go to your apps and the sections. Just click on explore more apps. From there, you can install EasyBI. And once the installation is done, you will be able to navigate on this page. So here, this is my account of EasyBI test. I'm the owner of this account, but if you are working under administrator, so administrator has to manage each and everything from their end. Now here we have source data. So whenever you will click on add new source data applications, it will take you to the new screen, and from there you can select it. Either you can select Jira instance or with REST API or with SQL or from even from the Google Sheet. If you have import definitions, you can also do it. So here I've already created source data. So I don't want to create it again because I'm going to use this source data for my this requirement. If you want to add it at any point of time, click on add it, and this will give you add it page where you can modify your requirements. So how we can add these fields? So whenever you'll click on this, you will get options to select your projects. I've selected few of the projects, which all options I want to import: epic link, import as property, sprint, then story points. And we can also select affected versions, channel, organizations, everything you can select it. But if you are unable to add, select this option, just click on add it and you will get options to select the check boxes. Here you will see all those projects which is available within your Jira instance. Based on that, you can select it. And once you enable this, you will get details of that project as well. Now in the custom fields, even you can see the custom fields options also enabled. So if you want to include these custom fields, it's very much possible to include it. Additional options are like JQL, that is Jira Query Language. If you don't know about JQL, feel free to refer my JQL playlist or JQL videos under Jira playlist. I will include the complete Jira playlist in descriptions. Other than that, I've already created specific course on Jira, which will help Scrum Master and Project Manager to learn from scratch. Feel free to refer this link for accessing this course, where you will get detailed understanding about how we can use Jira and use in day-to-day life as a Scrum Master and Project Manager. So feel free to refer this course. If you have any questions and suggestions, reach out to us. We'll be definitely happy to help you. Now, coming back to this section's additional options, from this, we can select time zone, first data of the week, or any other fields. If you want, you can modify it. Analyze options. Analyze options is giving us flexibility to create different reports. When I will click on new reports, it will give me options to provide the name. So which all fields I wanted to modify. And from here, based on this, I will get details. So here all projects by category I've selected. Reporter for all reporter, assignee, we can drag and drop assignee fields. These all fields we will be able to modify it. So here, if you wanted to particularly use on this issue specific, you'll also get some templates. But if you want to create your own templates, you can generate it quickly. So here, if I'm selecting this, and you can see this report is generated successfully. We did not change anything, but whenever you will change different attributes, you'll see labels are also available. Uncheck this and that label gone. Axis options, you can swap axis X or Y axis. So you will see the trends will look like that if you will swap this. And once you are done with this, click on Save As, and this report will be saved under your repository. So here I'm selecting sample Jira issues as a folder where I want to store this. Average resolution time and trend, lead time, and then here I'll add axis change. Now here also you can make this templates private for you, but if you want to make it public, don't check this box, otherwise that templates will be private for you only. Click on save this and you will have this templates added successfully. So this is a new templates. Based on your requirement, you can customize it. Even if you want to modify from bar chart to line chart, you will also see that result. Pie chart, with pie chart that is also available. Scatter mode, so you will get multiple options. However you want, you can modify it and use it as per your requirement. So analysis is helping us to create different type of templates, and based on that you can save it for your further usage. And whenever you want to create a new one, click on create new report. You can select any of the options, current, keep current selections or empty reports. You can use it and you'll get a new folder created for you where you can generate report for your requirement. If you want to open any of those reports, you can also open it. Let's consider this report. Here we have added reports which will give you issue created, issue results, average resolution days, and open issues. Here you can see all those tags like 500 days or 100 days. So these all informations are available. Now, if you want to just filter it out based on the projects, select the specific projects and that issue graph will be generated according to selected project. Here also you can modify it or use it multiple projects as well. So at once, so let's consider I want to use this one, and after that I will just press Control Tab and select the second one. So here we'll get options for multiple select, and once we'll click on multiple select, we will get an options to select other projects as well. And once you're done, you have to just click on OK and that project will be selected. So we have two options, one with single and second with multiple selections. So based on your requirements, you can use it for further need. Now this is a filter based on the project, but if you want to return back, you can select all projects and you will get your desired result based on selected projects. Here also we will get filter based on time frame or durations. So as of now we have selected for 12 months, but if you want, you can select the all times. So this will give you insight till here. Now, whenever you're making changes, if the dashboard is not refreshed, you can refresh it by using this icon. All issue types, we are also getting options to select some categorizations based on the issue types like epic, bug, initiatives, task, test executions, test plan. Based on your issue types, you can also modify it. And once the modification is done, again, you will get a desired result. Here also, we can specify according to the priority. If you want to just select highest priority, you will get options or dashboards generated based on your highest priority selections. Here, assigning fields are also there. This is not limited at all with any specific requirements. Even you can modify it based on your project selections. Here also you can modify it. And once you're done, just save this dashboards with your name and these templates. You can use it on the regular basis for any projects. So, which is not at all limited. And here also you'll get embed, report, or export definitions. Both options are available, where you can export it or import it with the parentheses. Now, next is dashboards. Here, we can create a new dashboard whenever you want. And if you want to add reports, simply select your generated report and that data is available. Now, once I will open this, you will see the result available here. If you want to add page breaks, insert a page break within the PDF export, you will get these options. And these reports are able to download into the PDF format. Can't export this dashboards, which is not saved. So as of now, it's not saved. That's the reason we are unable to get the result. But let me add this dashboard's name. So this is demo dashboard. And here we'll click on save changes. And if you want, you can download into PDF format. And this PDF files will be generated, which you can share with any of your team members. So the main pain points of generating a report in Jira, we are unable to export it. Either we have to take a snip of that project, or you can share the link with the external user or with the global audience. But by using EasyBI, you will get an option to download this report and share in PDF format. Now here we will get other options like edit, new, and all those. Let's consider we have built this dashboard, and after that you want to modify it or you want to add any other fields. So just click on add it, and from the report sections you can add as many as snippets, and that's done. Now once I've opened this, I will get result here. So this is based on sprints, story points, burn down chart, and if you want, you can use it at any point of time at the modification level. So here, once we are done, again you have to save it, and once you'll save it, you'll get two dashboards generated. Let's consider you have multiple dashboards and you want to download just one. So you'll get export report results from here, and you'll get four options: one with CSV, XLS, PNG, and PDF. All four options are available where you can download it. So this is very easiest way to use this EasyBI tool, where you can generate interactive dashboards. You can download these dashboards data and share with any of your team members, which they are looking or with whom they are relevant with this. So this is how we can generate any dashboards within a Jira instance, which will be helpful for us to quickly share with any of our team member. Now, we'll also get options to email the dashboards results, or even you can keep this settings private, where you can provide the access according to your requirements. So let's consider you don't want to share with the finance team. You can add the stopwatch, stop for the finance team, so that they won't be able to access your dashboard. So, or you can provide the limited user. You want to add the access to just limited user, that is also possible. In settings tab, you can modify the settings, all accounts details, and even the language option is also available. So here we'll have English, Dutch, France, and Latis, that is Latvin, which is possible to generate this dashboards in multiple languages as well. Now let's consider a scenario where your team is working across the globe and you have different mindset of people. Some team members are with German language, some team members are from the different other languages like English, and some are just understanding Latvian. In that case, you can download this report in all three languages and share with your team members. Those who are with the respective language, they will download their report and read it. So that's the benefit we will get it. This tool is not as small, which we are seeing here. In the top overview level, I try to cover as much as possible. But if you want more depth knowledge about this third-party add-on, feel free to add your comment in the comment sections. I will definitely try to come up with a few more videos. But the necessary conditions, unless and until I will not get 100 comments in this video, I won't be able to create new one. So based on your demands or based on your request, I will come up with new video on this specific topic. So start commenting and give me your notifications so that I can start building few more contents related to this add-on. And if you have any suggestions, you can always reach out to me to suggest any new topics which you want me to build it or which you want to learn from your side. We'll see you in further part of the video. Till then, happy learning. Thank you.